Let's step back for a bit to remind us why we're focusing on memory the way we are. Our overarching goal, of course, is just to make code fast. So we say, great, GPUs are fast. Let's use those. But why are they fast? GPUs are fast first because they are massively parallel, with hundreds or thousands of processors on a single chip working for you to solve your problem, but also because they have an extremely high bandwidth memory system to feed those massively parallel processors. Okay, so if the memory system can't deliver data to all of these processors and store results from all those processors, then we're not going to get the full speed out of our GPU. And that's why, on a memory-limited kernel like transpose, our sub-goal is really to utilize all the available memory bandwidth. Hence our focus on global memory coalescing, DRAM utilization, and so on. Now I really want to ask the question a little bit more rigorously. What do we mean by utilizing all the available memory bandwidth? And this is going to bring us to a very important, very simple principle called Little's Law. Let's have the talented Kim Dilla illustrate this for us. Now, John Little is an MIT professor who studies marketing. He formulated his eponymous law when writing about queuing theory and business processes. And Little's Law is usually used to reason about things like optimizing the number of customers in a line at Starbucks, or maybe the size of queues in a factory. But Little's Law is really very general and can be applied to many things, including memory systems and computers. In that context, Little's Law states that the number of bytes delivered equals the average latency of each memory transaction times the bandwidth. Let's be a little more precise and emphasize that we care about the useful bytes delivered. And the problem with uncoalesced global memory accesses is that not all of the bytes in every memory transaction are actually being used. That's why coalescing global memory accesses helps ensure that every byte delivered in a memory transaction will be used. So given this definition, what can we do to improve our bandwidth? Let's check all that apply. We can increase the number of bytes delivered. We can increase the latency, meaning the time between memory transactions. We can decrease the number of bytes delivered, or we can decrease the latency, or time between transactions.